Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. This is a beautiful afternoon in Nairobi. It's 14 hours and 30 minutes in Nairobi. My name is Pastor Jeff Gichuki, and I want to greet you good afternoon or good morning or good evening or good mid-morning. It all depends with where you're watching me from or watching us from or catching us from. It's a joy and a blessing to always come to us with the Word of God and with the moment to share God's Word and God's life and God's Word and God's the grace of God that is given to us. In the mighty name of Jesus, Jeff Gichuki is my name. They call me Pastor Jeff, and that's okay with me. And we bless the name of the Lord. So we're doing this program that we're calling Impacting the Nations. Impacting the Nations, and are going to be doing this for the next 3 days, same time. Today's Wednesday, tomorrow Thursday and Friday, and also do this next week by the grace of God, or a couple of days as the Lord allows me. And I believe that God is giving us moments and opportunities to just come to you, bring you counsel and bring you wisdom and bring you, the will of God. And I believe that you'll be blessed and be edified and strengthened in Jesus' name. Allow me to pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for moments and opportunities like this to share your word. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bless all my viewers right now. I bless all who have tuned in and those who are tuning in even right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray your grace upon each one of them. I pray your wisdom. I pray understanding. I pray counsel. I pray the Spirit of the Lord be on us. And may you do that which only you can do to the glory of your name. In Jesus' name, I pray and we pray. Amen. And a big amen. With impacting the nations. Impacting the nations. I begin by defining terms. When we talk about nations, that word nations has many meanings, but one of the meanings I love for that word nation is what is called ethnos, from where you get the English word ethnic groups. So when you talk about nations, we're talking about people groupings, people that share same culture, values, including locations, geographical locations. And when you talk about geographical locations, that brings in countries. Of course, in the preachings of Jesus and teaching of Jesus, the word nations most of the time is not used to refer to countries as we know them to be, but rather people groups. But that also still forms part of what I would be working with in impacting nations. And when you talk about impacting, is bringing impact. You know, that's the word I'm using, to impact and to impart. Those two words, you know, impartation and impact. Impact, rather, are very closely related, although they are different. So impacting nations, and that's the matter. And I want to appreciate all of you guys who already tuned in. I will be doing that later on, but I can see quite a number of you already with us, and the Lord be praised and be glorified. Amen. So impacting nations, that's a matter we dealing with. And I want to begin by reading Matthew 24 verse 14. The Bible says, and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, then the end will come. Therefore, and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, and then the end will come. It's amazing that these are the words of Jesus, of course, talking about end times. And so many signs of end times, you know, there are many signs of end time, including tribulation, persecution, wars, rumors of war, pandemics, plagues. There are many, many signs of end time. But I love this particular one when Jesus says the gospel of the kingdom. First of all, he calls it gospel of the kingdom. What is gospel? It's good news. And this good news of the kingdom, this good news of the kingdom of God. When you talk about kingdom, is that place we call king's domain, the territory of the king. This gospel about the Lord Jesus Christ will be preached, and Jesus says, to all the world. He says to all the world. It shall not just be preached to, you know, one particular area or just some little area or some specific region, but shall be preached in all the world. That means the four corners of the world, the whole world, the globe as we know it, everywhere. to the islands, continents, you know, big cities, little cities, villages, everywhere there is human settlement, the gospel shall be preached. The gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world. And the Bible says, as a witness to all the nations. And so you have two words here, world and nations. And one, of course, will be far more referring to the space, you know, all the world, you know, all the geographical regions. And then it shall be preached to the nations, meaning to people groups. And of course, you know, in the commission to the whole world, what we call the Great Commission to preach the gospel, Matthew 28 and verse 18, the scripture says, and then Jesus came and spoke to them saying, all authority in heaven, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth, all authority in heaven and authority on earth. Two places, the heavenly realms. And then the earth, which is cosmos, where people live, the physical, the ground, the earth. This authority is given to me both in heaven and also given to me on earth. And Jesus says, therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations. Make disciples of all the nations. Make disciples. Raise people who are going to be followers. They are going to be students. They are going to be learners of the word of God. Make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. So as we talk about imparting nations, I want you to know, my brother and sister, my viewer, that when you talk about nations, you are talking about all people from all countries, from all regions, from all walks of life, from all languages. What the scripture says, tribe, people groups, tribes, languages, nation, ethnic groups. You know, God is calling us to see that the gospel reaches everywhere. The gospel reaches everywhere. And so Jesus makes the pronouncement, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to the ends of the earth, shall be preached in all the world, shall be preached in all the world as a witness. It shall be preached as a witness. And then Jesus says, and then to all the nations, it shall be preached to all the world as a witness to all nations, and then the end will come. Now, the burden that has been in my heart for many years, and more recently, you know, it's revived in my heart, is, you know, the burden for the nations. The burden for the nations. I don't know whether, my viewer, it makes sense to you when you think about how right now the whole world is united in one thing called COVID-19 pandemic, you know? One virus that has caused the institutions all over the world, nations all over the world, governments, you know, all over the world, governments, we are all caught up in one thing. We are all caught up fighting the pandemic, fighting infections, reducing infections, dealing with the matter. I mean, right now, all over the world, something called mask is known, N95, surgical mask, all kind of masks, you know, and coming in all shapes and colors and sizes and tastes. And I can tell you, when God gives a word through Habakkuk, and say it should be Habakkuk 2:14, I will should be confirming that for us in a minute. And the word of the Lord there is that, you know, the Lord says that the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as water cover the sea. Habakkuk chapter number 2 and verse 14, that the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God. The earth shall be filled. Wow, Pastor Jeff is looking for finding out some of these books, by the way. It's not easy for all of us, you know, when you have using hard copy and you got to find out books like Habakkuk, Nahum, Zephaniah, Zechariah. They are not as easy as straightforward like Psalms. You know, when you're looking for Psalms and those kind of books, easy, straightforward. Habakkuk 2:14, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the water cover the sea. The earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as the water cover the sea. The world right now, we so much caught up all over the world talking about the virus and talking about infections, talking about economies and what have you. And I've been carrying a burden in my heart. What about the gospel? What about the gospel of the kingdom? What about us, you know, putting in energy, concerted energy to reach out to men and women, to reach out to children, to reach out all over the world? I can tell you that the systems of this world are not crafted to take the gospel, so to say. In other words, There is all manner of campaigns that will take place and do take place in the world about malaria. There are things, I mean, there are all these movements that are talking about, you know, sicknesses, talking about global warming, talking about all kinds of things. What about the gospel? Is it not time that we, every child of God, must begin to think about the gospel advancing to the nations and that being done with aggression? And that is a matter that has been in my heart, and that what I seek by the grace of God to keep sharing with us for a couple of days and this season. And I believe that God will inspire you up, and that God will bring a flame of fire, will kindle fire in your heart, that as we talk about global businesses, as we talk about global warming, as we talk about pandemic, global, you know, infections, as we talk about World Health Organization, as we talk about UN, you know, initiatives to keep peace across the nations, as we talk about all these wonderful organizations that help us do business regionally and globally, you know, we talk about East Africa, EAC, East Africa Commission, that are helping us do business in East African region, you know, all these African unions and all these great organizations that are out here advancing causes that make man's life better. We got to talk about how about the gospel. And today I begin by reading a few scriptures, and then I'll share with us what I would call simple ways to impact nations. Simple ways, just some simple practical ways that you and I can employ, should employ to impact the nations. And I begin by reading Psalm chapter number 2, verse 7 and verse 9. This, of course, is, this definitely is a prophetic word for the Messiah. I know it's a really prophetic word for the Messiah, but it still becomes part of our promises in the Lord. Verse 1, of course, begins by saying, "Why do the nations rage and the people plot a vain thing? The kings of the earth, the kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, 'Let us break their bonds in pieces and cast away their cords from us.'" Right from that portion, you see the kings of the earth, the nations, and rulers. You know, that sounds like, you know, all these wonderful global organizations, you know, world nations and others. Kings and rulers, they took a stand, and this time they took a stand against the Lord. And verse 5 says, what do they say? Verse 4 says, "He who sits in the heavens shall laugh, the Lord shall hold them in derision. Then he shall speak to them in his wrath and in distress, and distress them in his deep displeasure. Yet I've set my king on my holy hill of Zion." Verse 7, this is my verse of interest. I will declare the decree. "The Lord has said to me, 'You are my son,'" capital S. That's why I say this is a prophecy for the Messiah. Messiahic prophecy. "You are my son. Today I have begotten you. And verse 8 says, Ask of me and I'll give you the nations for your inheritance. I'll give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possessions." Not just nations, but the ends of the earth. "I'll give you the nations, and I'll give you the ends of the earth for your possessions." And verse 9 says, You shall break them with a rod of iron, and you shall dash them to pieces like a potter's vessel. What is the prophecy here for Christ is that the Father desires to give Christ the nations and the ends of the earth. Is that not the same place, Jesus, is saying this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to the whole world, so as a witness to other nations? And so the prophetic word here is, "Ask of me and I will give you the nations. I'll give you the nations and the end of the earth, the ends of the earth, as your inheritance or as your possessions." And ladies and gentlemen, we got to begin to appreciate that God's kingdom expands to cover the whole earth. In the visions of Daniel, you know, visions of Daniel, actually it was visioned by Nebuchadnezzar. He saw this vision. And Daniel is the one who gives interpretation. He sees this image that has a, you know, the head of gold, and then, you know, all that, and the feet were partly of clay and silver. And then he saw a stone coming, crushing that image, you know, a stone he says, Daniel says, you saw a stone cut from the mountains and not with the hands. That means it was not a natural, I mean, it was not a man-made, you know, man kind of activity. And it came and crushed the image and, you know, crushed it and all that. And Daniel explains and says that there's going to be four kingdoms and they have been there. But then in the days of those kingdoms, there shall, God shall set up a kingdom. He will set up his kingdom. And in the vision of Nebuchadnezzar, the image, the stone rather, grew, expanded, and covered the whole earth. And Daniel is saying that God will set up a kingdom whose influence, impact, shall cover the whole world, the whole globe. And we know that the kingdom of God, the church and the kingdom of God and the gospel is meant to go all over the world. It's meant to go to the islands, to the masses, to every corner of the earth. And so ask of me and I'll give you the nations and the uttermost parts of the earth for your possession. And then the promise there, you shall break them with the rod of iron. You shall dust them to pieces. In other words, you shall have rulership. You will rule. You will have influence. Jesus, the Messiah, is having influence all over the world. And what a joy to be, you know, to be given opportunity as a child of God to partner with God in that which he is doing. And so today, I want to share with us briefly on, share with us on what are some of the simple ways can you be involved in imparting the word? Simple steps or simple ways or simple principles, if you like, that you can employ in beginning to impart nations. Number one, you need to do what we call praying for the nations. Praying for the nations. Simple ways to impart the word. Number one, we begin at prayer. Now, when you look at the model prayer Jesus taught us to pray in Matthew chapter number 6, which is also in Luke 11 verse 1, Jesus taught us to pray and say, Our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Salutation, that is. Hallowed be your name. Your name is holy, set apart, sanctified. And then he taught us to pray, Your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your kingdom come, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth. Your kingdom come, your kingdom be present here, and your will be done on earth. Now, that will of God being done on earth is what we are talking about as praying that the nations will open up to the will of God. So as you think about how do we impart the nations, you know, because it's natural that every one of us, when you think about the whole world, we think about really this, you can't do much for the whole world. And many people resign to the position of, hey, we can do nothing. We can do nothing. The world is too big. You know, I am not the president of America. I'm not president of a big state. I'm not a governor of a region. I'm not a big business guru. So what can I do? I don't have an organization whose products are all over the world. What can I do? Brother, sister, there is something you can do. And we begin there. Praying for the nations. Praying for the nations. You know, the scripture in Psalm we've read, ask of me and I'll give you the nations. Why must we pray for the nations? Prayer and intercession unlocks destinies. Prayer and intercession unlocks destiny. And when we talk about prayer, prayer is what opens up regions. Paul says that an effective, he is asking brethren to pray for him. He says, for a great and effective door is open for me, but there are many adversaries. So we begin by praying for the nation. I want to ask you, when last did you pray for a different community from yours? When did you last pray for a country apart from where you live? When last did you take some time to look at the globe and look at some of the countries? Look at the little ones, look at the big ones. You know, when last did you take interest? You know, I used to watch a movie, or I watched a movie a long time ago called The Last King of Scotland. You know, these guys acting Idi Amin from Uganda, a neighbor, and there is a doctor, young kid there, whose parents ask him, what would he want to become and all that? And he says, he want to be a doctor. And then he takes the globe and swings the globe and places his finger on whatever country, who, and he touches on Uganda. And so he came to Uganda. Well, that's a movie. But the point is, what about the nations? When last did you take time to pray for the nations? I want to really encourage you. As we talk about, you know, imparting nations, you got to begin to pray if you have not been praying for countries. You know, just get a map, a good one. You know, I have one on my iPad. Just get some good one. be able to notice a number of things. Who lives there? What do they do? What is their economy? What kind of people? What are their faith? What is the predominant faith? And you can do simple research. A wonderful platform called Wikipedia. On Wikipedia, on your Google, you know, Gulugulu, a friend of ours from China calls it Gulugulu. From Google, you can check on Wikipedia especially, and you'll be able to see the populations, you'll be able to see the people's culture, you'll be able to see the predominant faith, you'll be able to see some of those things, and including simple things like I love to just look at what time, you know, the time differences and time zones. Like now is 1953 in Manila, our friends there is around the same time in Kuala Lumpur, same time, I mean, 1453 in Addis, 1353 in Cairo, you know, and all these. I love a country called Jakarta, Indonesia, and right now it's 1853 in Jakarta, Indonesia. What am I saying? You need to begin to pray for countries. You don't just take time. I begin to pray, and I want to encourage you, begin from the ones who are easier for you. Pick a country. If you are Kenyan like me, pick Uganda, for example. Begin to pray, oh Lord, I pray that you have mercy on Ugandans. Open the door in Uganda for the gospel. Touch the people of Uganda in the name of Jesus. Bring them to the light. Those that are caught up in darkness, bring them to light, Lord. May the economy of Uganda flourish, more so the church, the people of God, the sons of God, the children of God. Yes, we know right now, by the way, in Uganda, the churches are not yet open to gather. They are not yet allowed to gather because of this pandemic. So put in some time, pray for Uganda. And I want to encourage you, do that. You know, put in some time. Lord, may there be a move of God in that country. May you strengthen the evangelists. May you raise more preachers. May you raise more ministers. May the pastors and apostles and evangelists rise up in strength, in wisdom, in counsel, in understanding. Pray. Pray for somebody. Pick another country, pick Rwanda. Lord, we pray that you strengthen Rwanda. We pray strengthen their president, strengthen their economy, Lord, strengthen their airline. I like the airline. You know, strengthen them, oh God. May the gospel reach in to the Tutsis and, you know, the rest of the communities there, Father. May, you know, take up a country and pray. Simple ways of imparting nations. Begin in prayer. Begin in prayer. And I can tell you what, the more you pray over a community, the more you begin to be drawn to them in love. The more you pray for a community, the more you get drawn to them in love. I can tell you, I travel Asia, and some of the things I find in Asia are not easy. First of all, their cultures are completely different from the cultures I'm used to. I'm telling you, the first time I was in India, I can tell you it was a shocker for me. I mean, these guys live very nice communities. You know, our whole family of great-grandfathers and father-grandfathers and the entire family, that big communal family, living in one house and one homestead, and beautiful. We weren't doing a meeting in some place, I won't give you names of where, and Sunday morning this family asked us to come in and bless them. And we are seated there, and I'm looking, I say, wow, I just told the brother I was with, look at this, a huge number of people, one family. And so we tried to count, we decided to, the chicken me said, let's count. And we counted, we came to around 48, 50 souls, one family, 48. Brother, when you come to Akacha in Nairobi, one family now, two children, one child, three children, and as soon as you grow of age, the kids want to, you know, go get their own cubes. A friend of mine, you know, has a son, I even don't know how, I think he's 18 or so, he already has his own room, separate room somewhere, and so culture, the more you pray for guys, the more you begin getting attracted to them, and I invite you to pray for the nations. When you watch those news, you know, from all these whatever networks you connect to, whether BBC, CNN, ABC, CDC, FCF, whatever, you know, that's just making a joke. Some of those do not exist until they are created. Anyway, whichever channel, whichever method or wherever you get your news from, as you see those news, figures of countries where there was fire, some other places or flooding, other places, put in some time to pray. We impart nations in prayer, and that is where we begin. Jesus gives us a promise or gives us a word that the nations, the gospel shall be preached to all the world, to the nations as a witness, and you got to set some time to pray. And I need to keep encouraging, I keep encouraging people around me, and I encourage you today. You got to begin to appreciate that life is greater and broader than you. Everything, the thing called life, cannot have everything just rotating around you, around your need, around your trouble, around your challenges, around your desires. Life is not just about you. Life does not rotate all rotate. Everything must not rotate around you. There is much more to life than just you. And so I encourage you, as we talk about imparting nations, let's begin there, praying for the nations. Begin to pray for nations. I can tell you, I as I grew up, you know, I grew up in a Christian family, my brothers and sisters born again, parents preaching, and I grew up seeing my father climbing trees, preaching and walking long distances, preaching. And when I became a teenager and went to high school, and I still have quite a couple of friends we were with in high school, and I treasure many of them. One of them is a brother called James Morioki. I love the man. We do a couple of things together, and quite a number of guys who are in high school, you know. And I remember days when we would go to that town, because I was in high school that is, you know, situated within one of the towns in our, where I come from. And there was this time, there was a church, a ministry that would bring us what was called GSN, if I'm not wrong. That was a ministry by the brother who went to be the Lord recent trip, More Seruro. And so we'll go to this church on a Sunday afternoon, and they'll be playing the videos of More Seruro meetings. And I can tell you, those are the days I began to see countries and names of places I didn't have an idea. One of the places I got to see those days was Manila, Philippines. I would see, you know, some of those clips when More Seruro would be in the Philippines, in the Manila, preaching to these numbers and masses. And I'll look and say, wow, I have always known Manila paper. Oh, there's a place called Manila. And I began, you know, creating a desire, Lord, one day I'll go to Manila. The other, you know, places I would enjoy, you know, I would really have a passion for. Although I really didn't know exactly how far away they are from us. You know, was Jakarta, Indonesia, you know, and Java Islands, you know. And these are places I got to know those names as I watched meetings by More Seruro. Later on, got opportunity to watch Benny Hinn's, and I would see him in the islands of Fiji, you know, and places. And I can tell you what, as I watched those things, a desire began to develop in my heart. And I began praying for some of these places. And I praise the Lord that by His grace, I've had opportunity to be in Manila at least five times or so now in life. And I can tell you, I fall in love with the country and the place and the people. And we are praying and doing a couple of ministries there. Last year, we were doing pastors and leaders meeting in Manila. It was awesome, you know, and be able now to learn the different names, Makati, you know, and Metro Manila. I don't know who. Wonderful people. And we bless the name of Jesus. What am I saying? Praying for the nations. That is a very fast place we begin. You need to begin to pray for the nations. Begin to invest prayer for other communities, for people groups, for what have you. Praying for, you know, the missionaries out here. Praying for people who are doing their mission work and preaching and whatever they got to do, you know. I was in a country some time ago, and I found some couple from Africa, you know, that are stationed in a very difficult country preaching the gospel. And, you know, we got to pray with them and keep mentioning them before God in prayer. So, simple ways of blessing the nations. We begin at praying for the nations. Number two, we need to put in our resources towards world evangelism. What I say, giving for world evangelism. Giving for world evangelism. I can tell you, preaching the gospel is expensive, very expensive. And whatever is going on in this world, whatever thing, philosophy, or whatever goes on into the world has a cost into it. Now, let me say this. There are all kind of organizations that are funding crazy stuff, you know, crazy stuff. You know, LGBTs and others. There are organizations that are funding all kind of crazy stuff. And we need to say to the believers, and I need to say to you, brothers and sisters, all my viewers, I need to say to us, we need to consider funding the gospel. And my father in the Lord, Apostle David Juma, has this illustration he keeps on giving us. When Jesus was, you know, when Jesus died and buried in that tomb, you know, flesh dark tomb, the religious folk had a problem with the fact that Jesus had said you resurrect. And so they went to Pilate and requested that they should be given some soldiers to man the tomb, you know, and they sealed that tomb. The Romans would do that, you know, sealing places and, you know, securing places. And they sealed up the tomb where Jesus' body lay. But hey, on the third day, Jesus rose from the dead. And the Bible shows the stone was rolled away. And we know when we read the gospel that when these soldiers were asked later on, what exactly happened? And they began to give their story. We know and we learn from the scripture that they were bribed so that they do not acknowledge or say that Jesus rose. Rather, they should advance the theory that the disciples came and stole the body. Can you imagine a whole Roman soldier who risked losing his own life by lying, but they were funded to say that the disciples came and stole the body of Jesus? If somebody can fund the lies, if somebody can fund, you know, to advance, propagate lies, how much more must we fund the gospel? And I'm saying, how do we impart nations? Simple ways of imparting nations. You begin by praying for the nations. And number two, give your resources for the world, for world or towards world evangelism. And when you talk about world evangelism, there are very, very many people right near you that are touching the nations. And you should support them. It's only an excuse. People keep creating excuse. Well, I don't know who Bonke is far from me. Yeah, Bonke is actually going to be with the Lord. But the ministry is still going on, Christ for All Nations. And evangelist Daniel Kolenda is still preaching in Africa. They are still doing great things. And many, 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 many more. In fact, most of us, our very own pastors, are doing a lot of global evangelism, global ministry, whether by traveling or, you know, releasing materials into the world, or even online ministry. All these online platforms are opportunities for global evangelism, and they require money, they require resources, they require, you know, monies and funds. And every child of God should be committed in that area to give towards the touching the world. There are people all around us touching the nations. We need to commit ourselves to support them, both financially, in prayer, in materials, resources. You know, I read this story about people called the Moravians or Moravians, depending on how you pronounce that, Moravians or Moravians. And the story about this community called the Moravians, who planted many churches around the world a couple of years ago in history. Now, these guys had a policy that one family will stay and then one family will go abroad overseas or into another region to go plant church. The family left behind would work hard and do as much as they would manage to support the missionary family. So one family will be supporting another family that is doing missionary work. And that's how the Moravians did so much work that even in our own country, Kenya, there are churches who are under that movement, the Moravians. What is the point here? People gave themselves to the gospel and give themselves to the advancement of the gospel. And I want to encourage you, be a giver in this area of global evangelism. A couple of years ago, I was praying, I was in a night prayer meeting, and the Lord spoke to me a couple of things about the gospel and preaching and the call of God in my life for the nations and all that. And then I remember the Saturday, after the Friday night prayer, later on in the afternoon, I went leading worship into a church in one of the villages in our country, some interior place. They had asked me to go and lead worship, singing. I love singing, guys. And they had asked me to go do singing and what have you. So I came into this congregation in the interior villages, and I was leading worship. Of course, most of the songs in local languages, But then when I was done with that meeting, a young man comes up to me and says, "Well, I feel I want to be a blessing to you." Just a young man. And the guy in the village put in a $5 bill in my hands. That was something awesome for me. Right interior village, you know, just a locals. And this was not a foreigner, just a local. And the young fellow says, "I want to bless you," and puts in $5 bill into my hands. And I looked at that $5, and said to myself, God of heaven, the kind of place from where I got that money was, for me, it was such a miracle to get that kind of money. The point is not the amount, but the bill, the currency. That was what was amazing. And so I got the five dollar bill, put it in my pocket, and blessed the young man, of course, and moved on with life. And I kept asking myself, so what do I do with it? But then around that same time, our pastor was traveling to Switzerland. He was going to do ministry in Switzerland. When I learned about his trip to Switzerland, I said to myself, what an opportunity to sow the $5 bill into his hands as he goes to Switzerland. And that's what I did, put it in an envelope and place it in his hand, say, well, this is my contribution. And I was so glad to give that kind of money. You know, I mean, I was so excited in my heart that I'm putting in a different currency from mine to the hands of men of God, saying, hey, you can go take coffee. Of course, it's a little money there. Well, still a little money. It's still a little money up to now. But you can take coffee or whatever. You can add up. What I'm saying is, how do we reach out to the world? You got to begin to give, support, be involved in the world evangelism and funding. And I say to us, I have not seen anything as expensive as some of these ventures that are being done into the nations. I'm telling you, the gospel is so expensive. You know, just the flights, you know, the accommodations, the hotels and what have you. I'm telling you, it can be quite expensive. And not only that, even those who do it, even the ministering to the nations that is taking place even online and even through books and materials and letters and emails, it's not easy. It's not easy, it's not cheap. Somebody got to pay the price. And I want to encourage you, even as I put a post to today's broadcast, I want to encourage you that you got to be involved. And how do you get involved? There are all kind of ways to give your monies, including those of you watching me. You have many ways. You can even support me right now financially. I've got a website, www.jeffgichuki. You log in there and you have a place where you can do your donation, and you can give from whatever currency, from whatever country you are in. And that will still come to us and will be a part of the blessing. You can, those in Kenya, you can do M-Pesa. We have a till numbers 985083. It's a till number. You can do that. And I want to say to us, by the grace of God, it's such a blessing when I come across a man or a woman that says, hey, man of God, I want to support what you are doing. It keeps us motivated. It keeps us energized. It keeps us facilitated. I was just about to give you a story. I don't like this one. But 2 years ago, we had, I was doing some mission with my brother in far Southeast Asia. And we had this particular mission scheduled in one of the countries there. And it was so sad for me that we were in this country. We are supposed to fly out into this other one to go and do a couple of meetings. And we couldn't manage to do that. And why were we hindered? We were not hindered by demons. We were not hindered by governments. We were just limited by finances, you know. And it was sad for me that we are right in this country. And, you know, the guys, brethren on the other part of the world are waiting for us. That was going to be about 3 hours flight. Actually, four and a half hours flight. But we couldn't raise enough money, you know. It's just being honest. We couldn't raise enough money. Does that make us failures? No, it simply means we are trying. We are doing what we know we can do. And we are doing our best. And we couldn't fly into that country. But by the grace of God, last year, we were back to those regions. It was such a joy to fly into this country and bring them the gospel and bring the word of God and see the churches are thriving and great works are taking place. What am I saying? You need to not only pray for the countries and the nations and the advancement of the gospel across the nations, but you also need to participate. Will you do that today? Will you do that today? Would you seek to find out who in your neighborhood or in your area or among your friends or your local church where you're in, they're involved in blessing the nations and be part of that? And a friend of mine say, it is good to say thanks, but it's better to give thanks. You know, in other words, participate. That's all I had for today, and I bless the name of Jesus Christ. Before I'm off air, I want to appreciate all of you guys who joined with me, and let me check some of the responses coming to us today. In Jesus' mighty name, a couple of messages here, and we bless the Lord. All right, the Lord bless you guys. Thank you. Who is here? What is up in our pages? Evans Nyaga, man of God, is saying hallelujah. God bless you. And Nicholas said, tuned in. And Helen Kim from Tanzania is saying, I'm here. May the Lord bless you, young lady, and keep you well. I have a couple of pages. Let me see what is happening on these other side of my pages. And oh, thank you guys. See a lot of activity here. Pastor Lucy is here. Thank you. The Lord bless you. Rosanna Cleaners, you are blessed. You guys are blessed. And I see a couple of people. Margaret Kay is tuned in from US of A. The Lord bless you, Margaret. Long time. May the Lord keep you and your family and do you well. Alex Courier is with us, and a couple other friends with us. The Lord bless you and be gracious to you. The Lord watch over you. I see Arthur saying, I'm watching. May the Lord bless you, sir, and all the people around you. In Jesus' mighty name, time for let me to continue. I've got to put a pause here. And before we do that, I will be glad to pray with you and pray for you and just speak the word of the Lord over your life. As it's a joy to always bring you the gospel. It's a joy to come to you with these kind of forums. As I said earlier, I'm Jeff Gichuki. I'm coming to us live from Uzima Centre, Thika Rd Church of Distinction, based in Nairobi, Kenya, East Africa. We are here for you, preaching the gospel in and out of season. We have a broadcast that will be coming later on at 17:30 hours. Later on, I will be inviting you to join us for that particular program. Today is a teens program. We call it Teens Connect. It's coming up at 17:30 hours. That's 5:30 p.m. in the evening, Kenyan time or East African time. You'll do well to join with us tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going to be back, same time, talking about imparting nations, and I'll share with you a couple of more practical ways in which you can be a blessing to the nations, and that will be lovely, and God will bless you richly and abundantly in Jesus' mighty name. I'm praying, Father, I thank you for the opportunity to preach the word, and I thank you for the opportunity to bless the nations, and I thank you for the opportunity to advance the cause of Christ. Jesus, you sent us to all the nations of the world, and you said this gospel of the kingdom will be preached to all the world as a witness to the nations, and then the end will come. And I praise you today. I honor you today in the name of Jesus for the many men and women of God that are out there in the nations preaching the gospel. Some are out there as teachers, some are out there as doctors and professionals. They are doing professional work, yet at the same time advancing the gospel, reaching out to people in your word and by your word. And I pray in the name of Jesus, may there be strength to the church. May there be strength to the many missionaries spread across the countries and the nations of the world. As many, Lord, whose hearts are given over to the preaching of the gospel. We are praying right now in the name of Jesus. May there be encouragement. May there be strength. May there be goodwill in the name of Jesus. Protection, preservation by your word. I pray right now against forces of darkness that bring about discouragement, frustration, closing doors. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that the gospel will continue to be heralded and preached and proclaimed, and will continue to bear fruits all over the world in the name of Jesus. We give you honor and praise, oh God. There are many countries that are still closed up for the gospel. There are still many regions and democracies and kingdoms that are still closed up for the gospel. We're praying right now that there'll be openings in the name of Jesus. There'll be openings into these places with the gospel. That somewhere, somehow, as men and women of God goes into these regions doing businesses and doing whatever work they got to do, that even then the gospel will be heard in the name of Jesus. That as your word is, that none shall be lost, so shall it be in our day. That this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to the ends of the world. And then as a witness, and then the end will come. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. So the Lord bless you and keep you. I look forward to be with you tomorrow, same time. That is 14:30 hours or 2:30 p.m. East African time. And I want to encourage you to join with me and call us somebody. Let somebody know that, hey, there's a man of God that is talking about nations, and you got to listen to what he's got to say or what he's saying. And we'll also be creating time within this, broadcast, imparting nations to pray for our different, regions and ministers and ministries. If there are ministers or missionaries out there you'd want us to include in our prayers, we'll be glad to do that, because our passion and commitment is to the gospel. We live for the gospel. I live for the gospel. Our lives is about the gospel, and we got to reach out until every soul comes to the kingdom. That's all we have for today. The Lord bless you and keep you and watch over you. I commend you to God and the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among all who are sanctified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. See you next time.